Action.
So I had a pretty distant relationship with my father when I was growing up. So one of the most exciting moments for me was when I was 12 years old and he invited me up to Maine to go fishing with him. It was going to be like the first time I've really had some face-to-face time just with him, you know, getting to have emotional talks. He usually used my brother as kind of the liaison when we wanted to have a real conversation. But I really wanted to impress him because I thought of him as sort of a professional. So I bought this book at the Scholastic Book Fair. It's The Kid's Book of Fishing by Michael Rosen. Now, it kind of taught just the fundamentals, but given this book and over the years, I've kind of developed a working knowledge of fishing, which I want to impart on you guys. I think it's really important to learn a little bit about fishing. As human beings, we've been doing it for thousands of years, and especially in Korea, it's a huge part of your culture. So, for start, the fishing pole itself, the handles are most often made out of cork. Oh, just to start, we're going to talk about freshwater fishing for the sake of time. There's saltwater fishing, fly fishing, all different varieties, but the freshwater fishing pole is 5 to 7 feet long, and a common terminology is action. So if you see over here, fast, medium, slow, fast action means there's low flexibility in the plexiglass pole, so you feel it much more in your hand. Slow action, there's more bend, and you don't feel as much tug when the fish pulls in your hand, but there's more movement along the pole. These holes are called guides. That's where the line goes through to get to the end of the pole. The reel is the most expensive part of a fishing pole. There are a variety of different kinds. Here are three of them. On the left, we have a bait caster. A bait caster, you release the line with the bottom part of your thumb, and then hold the line with your top of your thumb, and it slides through, and you have to stop it. This is very complicated and for advanced fishermen, but a good bait caster can cast in about a circle that big with accuracy. The next is a spin caster. This is the most common kind used from intermediate to advanced fishermen. The release is just this little hook right here. You flick upwards, cast the line out, close it. This is for beginners. It's a closed spool rod. You just press the button, flick it out. Very simple. Automatically closes after you let go of the button. So now for bait. The bait is what's tied on to the end of the line. There's two basic subsects. There are lures and soft baits and hooks. The first lure we have is an interesting one. It's called a hula popper. It's used to emulate a frog hopping across the top of water. Now, granted, this is not the most effective type of lure to use, but it's very fun to fish and looks very interesting in the water. The second is a fake minnow. These are very commonly used, and they might not look very flashy just in that picture, like a white minnow, but in the water, they're made to shine as they wiggle back and forth. See the plastic on the tip of the mouth? When you drag it through the water, it actually emulates the swimming of a little fish. And bass especially find this incredibly appetizing. So now onto the fish that you can actually catch with these techniques. On the farthest left is my personal favorite. That's a freshwater bass. They're not picky. They'll eat pretty much any bait you'll throw at them, but they are incredibly sensitive to sunlight and temperature of the water. So in the beginning of the summer, when the sun is shining on the in the water, it's very hot on the top, so they like to sit lower. So depending on the season, you catch them at different depths. When it's coming into late September, where I live in the northeast of America, they come up right to the surface of the water, and on a cloudy day, you can put, as soon as the worm hits the water, the bass are already there because they're sitting right at the surface of the water waiting for food to come in. Salmon are very fun to catch. You fish them with very small bait. For such a large fish, they really do eat like small insects. So you cast out bait that floats on top of the water, and if you're lucky, the salmon will actually jump out of the water as if they're, you know, and like in the picture, catching the fly, and then you have to keep tension on the line. What makes salmon difficult is if the salmon jumps up, it creates your line to be loose, and when they slam back down, what makes the line snap is when it goes in and is slacked and then taut very quickly and snaps the line. Pike similarly do this, except their teeth are very sharp, and you catch them by trolling in boats. Trolling is a term that means you're in a boat going 2 miles per hour and you cast it out, and they dive very deep. So, in conclusion, fishing is much more about just much more than just the mechanics to me. It's very personal, and I hope all of you try it because it's relaxing and something that I think all of you would enjoy. Thank you very much.